Item number, SCP-430. Object class, Euclid. Special containment procedures. SCP-430 is to be kept in a humanoid containment cell on Site 17, placed on a wooden pallet or equivalent loose support at least 20 centimeters above ground to prevent rusting. The cell containing SCP-430 is to be fitted with an adjustable table, a sand basin, a controllable two-position hook conveyor system, and a master-slave control system, as specified in Document 430 Gamma Construction Details. One cell adjacent to SCP-430 is to house a live D-class subject, designated SCP-430-C, whose suitability was ensured by enacting Protocol Prometheus 11 prior to their internment. SCP-430-C is to be treated in accordance with Foundation Humanoid Containment Guidelines Section NP1. Suitable SCP-430-C candidates are non-violent, introverted, and capable of carrying out simple tasks without supervision, with claustrophobia being a disqualifying factor. Other cells adjacent to SCP-430 containment are to be designated long-term low-value item storage. The set of cells adjacent to SCP-430 is designated SCP-433. While SCP-430 contains a living subject, designated SCP-432, such SCP-432 is to be treated in accordance with Foundation Humanoid Containment Guidelines, Section NP5, except as following. Routine medical examinations of SCP-432 are to take place weekly, rather than monthly. SCP-432 is to be fitted with a heart rate monitor. Due to restricted movement, SCP-432 is to be fed an individualized diet, as per recommendations of a qualified member of Site 17 medical staff. SCP-432 is to be administered daily doses of aspirin to prevent vein thrombosis. SCP-432 is to be encouraged to perform light exercise within the limits of SCP-430's allowance. While no Foundation staff is present in the containment cell, SCP-432 is to have control of the table position, the lighting, and the hook conveyor system by means of the slave controller, unless deemed otherwise by staff of clearance 1-430 or higher. This controller is to be disabled from the main control panel prior to staff entering SCP-430 containment. SCP-432 is to be explained the functioning of the controls, and be ordered to transport their cell above the sand basin prior to urination or defecation. The sand basin is to be cleaned daily. In the case of SCP-432 expiring, as represented by the lack of signal from SCP-432 heart rate monitor, coupled with visual confirmation, no personnel is to enter SCP-433 until visual feed confirms the presence of former SCP-430-C inside SCP-430. Subsequently, the remains of previous SCP-432 are to be removed from SCP-430, and the new SCP-432 briefed. Protocol Prometheus 11. Prior to being classified SCP-430-C, chosen D-class personnel is to sign a printed copy of the following document. Note: following Incident 431, personnel are to ensure SCP-430-C has signed the document with their own name. Researcher Eisenberg. I hereby of my own will declare that I reject the divine mandate of our monarch, holding them to no more esteem than the lowest of peasants, for all men were born equal, and that I support, and urge my countrymen to rise against feudal tyranny, and fight for freedom, brotherhood, and equality. Undersigned. Description. SCP-430 is a cylindrical gibbet, approximately 3 meters tall and 0.7 meters in diameter, weighing ca 800 kilograms, composed of an unknown material. SCP-430 resists attempts to obtain bulk material samples, and attempts at indentation testing resulted in hardness values inconsistent with other properties. Vickers indentation test resulted in measured hardness values between 18 to 35 HV5, While subsequent attempt at sampling showed the bulk material being capable of causing significant abrasive wear of the diamond-coated cutting disc. Samples of surface corrosion are obtainable, and are chemically identical to hydrated ferrous oxide. On the lower rim, the numerals 1772 and name, Hans Dreschler, are carved. While SCP-430 is occupied by a living individual, designated SCP-432, it persists in a passive state. SCP-432 can interact with their environment outside SCP-430, subject to the imposed physical constraints. Even if feasible for their size and dexterity, SCP-432 will deny having the ability to exit SCP-430. If forced to exit, SCP-432 shows signs of mental distress and reappears within SCP-430 within 3 hours of removal. SCP-432 shows no other anomalous properties or traits. Individuals within direct sight range of SCP-430 form false memories consisting of alleged reason for SCP-432's presence within SCP-430 in the form of a transgression SCP-432 has committed. The memories are consistent among test subjects. When SCP-432 expires, SCP-430 enters active state. During active state, SCP-430 attempts to locate a suitable individual in its vicinity, with a radius of effect expanding by ca 10 meters an hour, with unknown upper limit. Testing aborted after radius of effect exceeded 300 meters. A suitable individual, defined as one who has transgressed against laws and regulations of the Royal City of City Council, valid during the period of 1766 to 1780, and who is within the effective range, will be instantaneously transported into SCP-430 through an unknown mechanism, becoming the next SCP-432. SCP-430 appears to show strong preference for individuals who have committed crimes against church or feudal authority, such as blasphemy, treason, and poaching. Recovery log. SCP-430 was recovered from Western Germany, following a police raid on a compound owned by members of Die Sohn von Magdalena, or Sons of Magdalene, as a result of witness reports detailing Hans, a member of the task force, appearing inside SCP-430 after attempting to aid its previous occupant, who was wounded in the firefight and subsequently expired. A modified report detailing his death during the operation was published, and members of the task force were administered Class A amnestics. Addendum 431. Sons of Magdalene. A fringe Christian sect led by a Johann. Members of Sons of Magdalene venerated SCP-430 as a living manifestation of God's judgment, and considered SCP-432 holy martyrs, usually providing them with drinking water, honey, and insects, as a reflection of the fasting of St. John the Baptist. In its original location, SCP-430 hung from the roof, behind the altar of the compound's church, with a sheet of worked sheepskin with the following inscription covering its lower half. For Mary Magdalene was sinful, but she knew of her sin, and repented in the face of our Lord, and was thus blessed. And the scribes and Pharisees who brought her forth and willed to stone her knew of her sin. But they were sinful, and did not know of their own sin, and thus were damned. And Lord Jesus said to them, "He that is without sin among you, let him first cast a stone at her." And blessed were the men and women, for they learned of their sin, for they have walked the path of salvation. Addendum 432. Incident 431. On date expunged, SCP-430C failed to appear within SCP-430 following expiry of then current SCP-432, even after 1 hour since event. 153 minutes after event, researcher A. Novikov disappeared from his office, becoming the next SCP-432, with observers citing charges of sedition and less majesty. When interrogated, SCP-430C admitted to signing the document with researcher A. Novikov's name, claiming to have overheard it from security personnel and citing, "I never signed shit with my own name, and not gonna start now," as a reason. Examination of the signed sheet confirmed this finding. SCP-430-C was terminated on disciplinary charges. Researcher A. Novikov was provided with a computer and continued his work until death. Lesson complete. If you missed the previous orientation, go watch SCP-429, Clockwork Teleporter, right now. Or for the complete course, watch this playlist.